Hello and welcome back to Star Trek New Worlds. And when we last left off, we made first contact with the native people of the Tau system. And although we ran into a little bit of difficulty, thanks to this being a completely blind playthrough, and neither the tutorial nor the manual making a particularly good job at explaining things, well, we had a couple of roadblocks along the way, but we managed to pull through and complete every single objective bar one, because well, the APCs, they need special handling apparently. And well, the Klingon Time Command seems to have been relatively pleased with our performance, which means we should move ahead with the second mission of the campaign, which is titled The Green and the Grey. So the Greens are probably the Klingons and the Greys are probably the aliens, so it will be time for revenge, since them attacking our ships without provocation was an inexcusable insult apparently, at least in the eyes of the Klingons. So well, we just head off here and see what we can find, and there should be a lovely briefing again.
Kihim! The next planet targeted for colonization is Ixion, a volcanic world on the outer arm of the Tabula Rasa. Typical of the anomaly systems, Ixion is M-class, rich in minerals and populated by the Taubat. Curiously, we have been invited by the Taubat government to settle there. Your performance on Tal impressed the Taubat.
That's suspicious.
They have apologized and now seek our aid rather than our enmity. The jump from anomaly space to our quadrant has shaken all of Taubat society. On Tal, it sent the locals insane. On Ixion, it has led to a rebellion. The government lacks the starships and army needed to put down the rebellion, and they have requested our help. In return, they offer the Empire exclusive mineral rights.
Is that
rights
so?
That even a Federation lawyer could not contest. Our announced goal is to crush the Taubat rebels. Starship scans reveal a buildup of activity at their base. Possible preparation for a major attack. We have landed a force of disruptor tanks and photon artillery at our colony. Deploy these in a defensive cordon to protect the allied Taubat settlement immediately upon assuming command. The civil war is religious in nature, so the rebel assault will inevitably concentrate on the allied Taubat temple. You must ensure its survival. Like its counterpart on Tal, this structure is weak, in a poor state of repair. If we recalibrate its dilithium reactor, we will increase its power output. Doing so will give you considerable leverage over our Taubat allies.
Yeah, allies.
However, the High Council wants you to go beyond the role of peacekeeper. Your successful defense of the allied Taubat is to be followed by a punitive attack on the rebels. Locate their base and destroy it.
Oh,
sensors have detected a number of unusual warp signatures around Ixion, implying that the rebellion is sponsored by an outside force. If so, the rebels pose a significant threat. To ensure the security of the Ixion colony, it is imperative you conduct a full tactical scan of the Rebel Taubat base to ascertain what aid has been given, who sent it, and how to neutralize any threat they pose. The High Council does not trust either Taubat faction. You are to cooperate in order to establish the Ixion colony, using the Taubat to legitimize our claim. While you must wear a smile on your face, keep your knife sharp. It is a priority for the safety of the colony,
and
you reach Potifagas security status. You will therefore build a perimeter ring of defensive weapons and a colonial defense force as soon as possible. Once again, you carry the honor of the Empire on your shoulders. Do not hesitate, do not flinch, just strike. Karga!
Got it, sir, but there seems to be a rather steep difficulty spike after last mission. Not only do we have to defend some allies, yeah, that could be a little difficult thanks to the usual pathfinding issues and our inability to detect enemies from further than 10 meters away, you know, allowing them to bypass our defenses all the time. Okay, but maybe we can manage. We have to keep that stupid power reactor online apparently, but I smell a big, big trap here. Something is not quite right in my book. Okay, so... yeah, all right. Yeah, so this is our base. Of course, we have to set up some basic facilities and we need to move these vehicles at the earliest convenience. So where are our friends? Probably over here someplace. It seems to be the temple, yes. Okay, we move at the first opportunity with our phaser tanks to provide protection. I think that's how this, yeah, friendly structure must be there, that's right. Okay, let's double click to check the brief. And apparently is the... also not really... okay, so where is the base then? Right, we do not know, apparently. So this is our storage facility, so maybe it's not where we are supposed to go. Okay, can we move a little higher? Maybe we can find out. It should be marked on the minimap, right? So we don't have to or want to do scouting, ideally. Let the get-go. Yeah, well, we would like to make good our promises if we can find your base for that matter. So we just wait here and see what our science vehicle can do. Because at the moment, I don't see anything else. So, okay, let's get busy here, build some facilities. We need the construction yard first, of course. And something we can outside the concrete slabs, apparently, which is something we should utilize. Okay, we have two photon artilleries. Yeah, so, now we don't have a scout with us, like period, is that correct? We can cycle through our vehicles just to find out. So a couple of phaser tanks or disruptor tanks, a couple of artillery pieces. Okay, I do not see the okay, well, where though? I am not seeing anything on the minimap, to be honest. Yeah, I'm not seeing anything, and we cannot switch to it apparently, so we just have to see where they are by moving our proper vehicles, I guess, and by we focus our attention on the base defenses. So this thing can be upgraded by the way, which something we should do. So the construction art is online, which means we need a research.
Colony is under attack.
Yeah, okay, already. Is the tempo over here someplace? Okay, go here, please. Thank you. I know, but I'm more worried about our allies at the moment. Yeah. Okay, I just upgraded. Yeah, we need to clear up a couple of buildings here. For instance, a power generator. Probably on the other side of the base, just to make sure it doesn't get destroyed as easily. And two should do the trick for now. Something like that, please. And then we clear up the resource processor as well, if you can. We also need to put up some disruptor turrets, and hopefully they will be unlocked automatically this time around. Okay, we put it on this side. Yeah, once again, we don't actually know where the, yeah, we don't actually know where the base is. Could have not have told us in advance, you know, it would have been helpful. Science station, yeah, for these disruptor turrets. I guess we can just go over here for now.
Power generator complete.
Yeah, I really don't know where they are. So the base must be here someplace. Let's see about our objectives though. Okay. 5 study disruptor systems. So okay. Well, I'm not quite sure. Vibot enemy tower, but anything else then? Survey the area. Okay, so this is only the one showing up, which means it's a little confusing to read. To be honest, but in some way we can get used to, of course, but they came from the right someplace, so maybe just do a little bit of scouting. And since we don't have a proper scout vehicle with us right now, we just have to see what we can find. So vehicle yard, for instance, that would be swell. Even though it's only the basic APC. Okay, vehicle yard needs to go on these concrete steps no matter what, I think. So we put it right here. Train station is being worked on. The resource processor as well. Do we need anything else right now? So upgrade the yard as well. Thank you. So we have a couple more vehicles over here someplace. They seem to be... maybe I just saw some on the minimap, because apparently not... yeah, maybe I was just seeing things. Could be the case. Mineral fields, that means we should set up a proper mining outpost on this side as well, because it's the lithium and quite important to us, so this is impossible, it must be the map edge then. Okay, if they have a base someplace, it's probably over here, so we check it out very brief. Put another mining station for that matter.
Science station standing by. So.
Okay, off to a hectic startup, I have to say. And yeah, things involving scanning, that seems to be a little bit clunky in this game sometimes. So hopefully we can do this without blowing up the structures we are supposed to scan in advance, such as the enemy base. Okay, so there can, this is space for one mining outpost, thankfully. And yeah, so this is a very rich field, but we don't have a VCOM vehicle right now. We have not been provided with anything really. Okay, maybe we can fix this, so queue up a couple of vehicles. We worry about the secondary ones first, so one scout at the very least, or maybe two. I'm not quite sure how we are surviving here, because as you can see, this is a volcanic planet, but it's barely habitable apparently. So that was the initial attack, and it's up to us to find our allied base apparently. So.
Construction vehicle complete.
Maybe move our engineer in there just to make things a little easier for us. And science officer can move into the recon vessel. I think that will also do the trick, but it's not a science vessel, so we cannot scan or at least not satisfy these objectives, apparently. That's from what I remember. So, back to my original Tano Fort. Is that engineer? Okay, you go here, please, and then we'll also train him up a little bit, and maybe we can also science engineering. That's good.
Resource structure complete.
Okay, yeah, putting operations officer in the structure will give us a minor bonus, but they are not specialized, so only so much we can do with this. A couple more of those, please. Hopefully this will do the trick, and then I think we could have a couple of transport bees at the very least, so maybe if we do the trick for now, so we don't outpace our pop cap, that would be swell. So the VCOM Vico. So we set it to, set one, and then we send out some merry way. Maybe we find out it should be a little faster. Apparently, it's impossible to go there. Alright, and we should have a second scout. Should have a second scout ready for us as well. We can proceed without the science officer for now, and we assign him task group 2. Maybe you find out something over there. Apparently not. Okay, so that came from the, not quite sure, to be honest. Okay, there seems to be another spot for a mining station. I can queue up one right away, and they are a little bit shielded, but they don't set up to a concentrated fire, of course. It will be up to our defensive turrets, which we cannot build at the moment, of course, since we need the science station online upgraded. I think this thing is supposed to unlock the, the disruptor turrets is the tracking sensor array or something like that. Didn't exactly work last time, so hopefully this won't reoccur because we need some steady defenses. I can't build too many vehicles at the same time and also divert my attention because they're rather useless when it comes to intercepting incoming attacks, apparently, or these attackers. Okay, there's the. Well, so it is nearby. All things considered, well, then we just move our vehicles over there until we can find. Interesting. So let's see what we are looking at. So this is there. I'm not quite sure what the equivalent is, but these have a couple of vehicles to defend themselves. I think we have to scan with an engineer, apparently. So good job. Finally, we found our allies. Quotation mark. So the base must really be. Yeah. So the base must be really to the other map edge someplace.
Science station standing by.
Alright, this is something that we can work with. So let's get back to base building. So this has been upgraded partially. Yeah, disruptor matrix 2%. I'm not sure what any of that means yet, to be honest. But hopefully we can unlock the turret pretty soon. So anything else we need to build right away. Construction yard is being upgraded. Something we already have. Transporter pad. I don't think it's a massive concern, but we need more vehicles as part of the mission objective, so we need to set down a sick bay. Also, we can research the data once we have a science vessel available.
Science station standing by.
Mine advanced power generator. Yeah, I think it's also a mandatory building you need for this. So then we also I think we are outpacing us a little bit, but we also need more power. So I don't want to. Yeah, we have plenty of space available.
Building
we can
construction
just.
Delayed.
Okay, we are low on the lithium at the moment. unsurprisingly. So tracking system. Yeah, that's the one I was talking about. So, since we've only one resource processing unit by now, maybe upgrade this one to the maximum. Is anything else we have seen on scanners? So apparently not. Well, not everything is impossible here, is it? Otherwise, why could we go all the way to the map edge, yeah? Hopefully, these guys... Oh, there's another attack incoming. Well, I don't think we will be getting there in time to try to intercept them, because our hover tanks are so slow to move. Get them in here, please. Are they attacking our base or trying to get to us? I'm not quite sure. Okay, just park them here and then hope we offer some meaningful resistance. Because the structures there won't last forever, even though they will get repaired over time. So, hours probably. Okay, sickbay is online. I want to put the pop cap, so it's mighty low already. So, I guess we invest a little bit of money to make the time. I think it's 5 each or something like that. Okay, the artillery pieces are very slow as usual. Okay. Special weapons, I think it unlocks the Klug tank if you want to use it. Maybe for the attack later on, it could be great. Specialist yard, that should unlock all the vehicles. Okay, yeah, that's something we don't need to know at the moment. And finally, we have to. Yeah, so why didn't you tell out about education first? It is a little depressing to me, but okay, we have to take it. And we need lots of power to power these turrets, of course.
Building construction delayed.
Okay, one power generator at a time, and then we'll see if it's already in the build queue. So, the ship generator, also important. Advanced power generator, so we have to be a little more patient, as it would seem. Yeah, so. Let's see. Over here, please, I want to see what's going on. Multi selection, yeah, so that's really, I don't think we can control them too wide. Apparently so, because it's certainly not our vehicles. Ah, interesting. So they're granting us control over their vehicles, but apparently, that's what I thought, so they are of course still under their control. Okay, where are our vehicles? Are they still moving in? Ah, these slowpokes, man, come on. Yeah, okay, so Vicon has not found anything of interest right now, as it would seem. Maybe did they get blown to bits, that could also be if the case, because, well, at a turret base, yeah, so, yeah, one science vehicle has disappeared from the, formation order, so there must be their bases over here someplace, okay, makes sense. Yeah, but why can't you select these vehicles and get the vehicles across if you're not actually in control of that vehicle, that's the door, okay. Oh, so this one, I'm not sure what it seems to be. So there's the base. Okay, we have found it. Also, it is one of the structures, right? Okay, we just jump to here and then see what we can see. With the... well, maybe we can do a little more scouting. And hopefully, yeah, the vehicle that got blown up wasn't actually one with our science officer inside. That would be unfortunate. So there must be a path to get over here to the other side. That is to be expected. Okay, we queue up a couple of vehicles. Starting with these phaser tanks, if they're already unlocked, that would be great. So 5 maybe do the trick for now. I think that was the requisite objective anyway. And they're rather squishy of things considered, especially when we are up against the proper base. Okay, I can barely see anything because of the camera angle. So there's our scout. And we have the Rebel base. This is their vehicle yard. This is, I'm not quite sure what it is, but we should be scanning this anyway, right? Both inactive vehicles at the moment, which will not remain for that very long, I'm pretty certain. I'm not quite sure how close we have to get to scan things for that matter.
Vehicle complete.
I don't see any defensive turrets, but alright. Okay, science scan, maybe do it. If things get a little too hot, we scoot out of here right away. Apparently, is it possible? Alright, no abnormal. So we can scan this from quite a ways, that's good. No anomalies, alright. What about the vehicle yard then? I don't think that's the proper vehicle. Probably need a science one for that. Anomalies, okay. So, it's interesting. Our colony is under attack, yeah, so okay, we at least leave that scout here for now, because it doesn't seem to be any danger, from what I can tell. But so, okay, yeah, well, fantastic. That bypassed all defenses again, didn't they? So, where can we... There's our phaser tanks we just built here. Can you please go over there before they blow everything to bits? Could be slow. Hello, guys. Please wake up. Thank you. Yeah, so there's the first building destroyed, fantastic. That's why we need a steady defense, of course. Yeah, same goes for you, please. Come on, get over here. Anything else that blasts into bits seems to not be the case. Wow, so that's a disaster verdict to a certain extent, I suppose. We have to rebuild one structure though, since I kind of got preoccupied with scanning the enemy base to know where it would seem. So I think the arsenal would is, what they blew up. And can we finally, set down some turrets or be slow? Once again, what are we missing?
Vehicle complete.
Some of the tanks vanished, but we need a couple more of those, I'm pretty certain. And the allies actually helped us out in this case. So this has been fully upgraded. So the colony has been upgraded, so the construction has as well. So once again, I'm not quite sure why we cannot set down anything in particular. And that is not because of this here. But maybe these are actually coordinated by the arsenal, that would make sense. Our ground defenses and all that. Okay, so let's see about our science officer, where he is. So he's off. So he was in the wrong vehicle, unfortunately, which means we don't have access to a security officer, to a science officer right now. But maybe put him. Yeah. So okay, that's obviously
vehicle
something we have to keep in mind. So we need a science vehicle. Sick bay standing by. Okay, it's not that tank's finished. So that's interesting. But I don't think it's actually what they want us to do. Maybe we can check with the objectives again just to find out. Yeah, so that's not something we can do at the moment, unfortunately. The security system's coming online, so hopefully that unlocks the turrets. Yeah, that's something we have done yet. We have to wipe out the enemy base. And then also survey the enemy base, yeah, but something we actually tried to do, but failed, at least with the one vehicle we have access to at the moment. At least that was already in the vicinity.
Vehicle complete.
So there's the shield generator, which became unlocked, but otherwise, Arsenal. I mean, so again, what do we need? What are we missing? According to manual, it's only that one thing in the science station, which we have already upgraded to the maximum. This construction yard is also fully upgraded. Yeah, this is the construction yard too, right? Okay, maybe try some other buildings then, such as the, what was it called? Yeah, the teleporter pad, and it should give us a couple more resources from off-world at the very least, since there's a starship in orbit. A lovely cloak board of pay, probably. A sick bay is fully upgraded, and I don't think it's tied to the problem or anything that is. And if it is, well, it's not explained in the menu, unfortunately. So, once again, we just have to figure these things out over time through experimentation. But it did become unlocked eventually, you know, in the last mission anyway. So we have to rely on all static defenses again, so that means our vehicles, which aren't particularly intelligent, or at least the drivers aren't, and they aren't really fully automated either way. Okay, so I guess we could pick a couple more of these tanks, and our science vehicle should be standing nearby for orders. If I can find it. Apparently they moved to a different rally point, is that not correct?
Transporter pad standing by.
We can just cycle through them.
Vehicle complete.
It's not ideal, but so that is it not? Yeah, there's the science vehicle, so it can just park itself here, and then we put the, probably the medic officer inside, or maybe the, I think this is an engineering matter, so maybe, but I think, yeah, so we cannot select him anymore, unfortunately, but he will be available next mission, or maybe once we set down the teleporter pad. So hop into this Vigon vehicle, please, and then we assign you formation one, probably. Yeah, so there we go. Was it over here, please? So the tow base is so intact, it's good. Once again, I'm at a loss as to why we cannot build these disruptor turrets. we scan, yeah, maybe this has to do with the order of the objectives, but we should be independent of those. So, yeah, so this actually, well, so in this case, apparently not necessary. Yeah, but, I mean, it would not make sense to me that we would be required to build the shield generator first before anything else. And the colony house, well, it's only for basically a pop cap, I believe. But this thing is being worked on, sickbay is already online, and I don't see anything else that would be a requirement. So I guess we just have to build all the structures and see if they unlock things or not. So the colony house, please, get to work. And then I think the only thing else we're looking at is the shield generator, so maybe to make sure that the arsenal doesn't get blown to bits. Maybe actually the security officer has to be stationed in this thing, could be the case. I guess we could give this a try, since we have one idling in the... yeah, there he is. I mean, would make sense to me, but it's the only thing I can think of really. Since something I did last mission anyway, I believe. So what's going on? Who is fighting? Also, they're making themselves useful in the base, okay. So our artillery obviously can shoot further than these tanks, which don't be very very smart, as you can see. But at least we're keeping the base safe to a certain degree. Okay, we also need to stabilize that tempo creation mark, the power generator in some fashion. Okay, is the science vehicle getting over here? Oh, so goddammit. Can you please make yourself useful and blow up these idiots? Thank you. So did that get blown up again? Are you kidding me? It was on route, it got blown up by some idiot. So that was even our science vehicle, wasn't it? Yeah, because I no longer is no longer available yeah, on the minimap or for that for the hotkey for that matter, so we have to go for another so I really have to babysit these stupid things here. Okay, build two. That's really not good because we're running out of competent stuff, aren't we? Yeah, so the medical officer is off planet and the science officer as well, so I'm not quite sure we can yeah, satisfy the objective stand. That's fantastic. It's lovely, absolutely lovely. So can we please park a blocking force between us and the enemy forces finally? Shouldn't be so hard, folks, right? Okay, but we can build another mining station, it's not a massive problem. There should be plenty of resources nearby. And yeah, our vehicle has also been destroyed. Because I don't know sure how, and maybe need another one of those as well. So it'd be easy peasy and fairly cheap anyway. Yeah, please do so, ground scout. Ah, so finally they have become aligned, so maybe it's just a matter of moving the science officer inside and then waiting, no, for him to coordinate the defenses. Okay, let's see about our power situation. So we have a little bit to spare, which is good, and I think the attacks were mostly coming from the north and the west. Okay, we set up a couple of doors and hopefully they will do the trick and then we can focus on hammering down the base. Yeah, so livestock that actually takes off drain from our replicators from that matter. So that's another building we can build for every faction ideally.
Vehicle complete.
Alright, let's build it here some place and then we set up our defenses. I think it's probably a little too trusted, but we will learn as to what our proper base should look like over time. Okay. We have power, this will take away some drain anyway. So let's keep a couple of those. We need 5, I think. And there we go, so static. One here perhaps. Maybe one per side will do for now because the enemy doesn't seem to be as fierce, at least at the moment. Yeah, okay, I get it. Who is fighting? Where are we? We are not even in wood, are we though? Ugh, Rebo tank, okay. Tompot house.
Livestock farm ready. Hold. Objective completed.
Okay. Orions. So these are the enemy pirates in the Star Trek universe. Ah, so I'm apparently. Okay, so that's something we have uncovered. So what is going on? Are our vehicles trying to pass through here or what? Oh, you have to be kidding me with this. What are you doing, folks? Don't fly into the enemy base? Are you kidding? Are you crazy? Jesus Christ. Okay, we have discovered the origin of the assistance, but we suicided a couple of our vehicles because they were absolutely stupid, because they're not supposed to go in there. I parked it on top of the plateau, didn't I? Well, then it was money well spent and also resources, of course, since they're not infinite in this game. Okay, so. Okay, they are behind the revolt and they're exploiting the situation, but the same goes for every single major empire, be it the Klingons, the Federation or the Romulans, and of course we have some minor planets as well. So that's fantastic. Good job, folks. Why did you even go down there? I did not click down there whatsoever, except with no one. Yeah, not even by accident. Okay, what's the damage? Okay, we have a couple of tanks available still. And I told you to get over here, not fly through the enemy base. Yes, thank you. Queue up some photon artillery pieces if you would. Maybe 5 will do. They're not very doable, and we don't need to capture anything, as far as I can tell, right? We don't need any NPCs, really, but maybe if we can take over the temple, that would be slow. So, what about that science vessel of ours? Has it finally been replaced? Yes. It's the science vessel, yes. Okay, science vehicle. Then we do a little bit of scanning on this power device of theirs, if we can. Right over here, then we try to make something happen with the remaining stuff we have on hand because we got everyone else killed, apparently. Okay, and they are refusing to move. Yes, lovely. Get over here, thank you. Yeah, we have to wait for their confirmation, otherwise they won't move. That's also good to know. So get over here, then we check what the situation is because I saw another pair of vehicles being dispatched our direction probably. And we also need to set up a second mine if we can, but the terrain seems to be a little hilly on this end. But maybe we can find one spot someplace to make this happen. And there we go, fantastic. So what about these fan stones? I think most of them we've put up our online on Valley. Then we check with the power situation and we have ample supply. Let's focus on base defense, then we build some vehicles and then we move on and deal with the rebel base. Okay, one over here just to be on the safe side. And then it should ensure overlapping fields of fire, maybe a couple of artillery pieces as a contingency plan, because they should be able to shoot over our buildings for that matter. Yeah, maybe one here for instance. And another one to the north, perhaps, or to the south even. So proton defense, and yeah, this is possible of course, so...
Vehicle complete.
Alright, another our power generator. So there's some artillery pieces of ours coming online finally. Okay. Oh, not this again. I thought I fixed it. Well folks, there we are again. I made a couple more changes in the DXWnd to hopefully make this game a little more stable, and now we can hopefully focus on the remaining portion of the mission and build ourselves a couple of, yeah, as one science vessel for instance, and these lovely disruptor tanks, and we also need to rebuild our base facilities of course, as well as the base defenses, and as before I don't actually know which order is required to actually unlock these things. Also, we once again try to put our science officer in the arsenal and see if we cannot build anything else from that, and I think the science station needs a couple more upgrades as well, which we cannot do without upgrading. I'm not quite sure if it was the construction yard, I believe, so that's something we should do as well. And I also found that our vehicles are actually rather adept when it comes to the defend order, so you can set them in your base someplace and they will hover over there automatically to engage targets of opportunity. That's something we may be able to do, and also keep our allies alive for that matter, but they seem to be more interested in coming our way anyhow, as far as I can tell. At this point in time, and yes, they are remaining passive when it comes to our scouts and their verities. Yeah, so the Orions have been discovered once again, and we have to eliminate them as well, and yeah, we're also mining the resources of all our supposed allies as well, which is kind of funny when you think about it. Okay, we don't need two scouts over there, and hopefully this would work in this case. We have a couple of phaser tanks, and they should just... make them successful in some fashion. We also need to scan the temple, I believe, which is what we need the scout for. Hopefully it can do this without getting eliminated, yes. Let's see if the order actually works, and they're on their way. They respond to all attacks in the nearby vicinity, I believe. Alright. Hopefully we won't be stupid again and fly through the enemy base, but at least we survive and lift the tear for a change. I think this is impossible anyway, isn't it? You'll see. Okay, get back to the base and see what the outcome was. So I did a relatively good job, so very commendable there, our lovely assault tanks. Yeah, so there we go. I think all the enemy opposition has been taken care of for now. And yeah, we also need to build more vehicles, of course. So can we finally proceed with the base defenses again? That would be swarm. So once again, the shield generator is nice and all, but we need more. Maybe this comes down to power, not having large enough surplus can also be the case, I'm not quite certain. There's no tech tree in the menu in case you're wondering. Yeah, so we already have that. Sick bay. Okay, maybe this will be required before we run out of the pop cap here, but it's actually also mighty close already, so that's a good thing I noticed in time. Instead of queuing up more of these utility vessels, for instance, colonial horrors. Wait, there's our sent down as well, since we have plenty of mines active right now. So apparently, ordering our security officer into the arsenal did not fix our problem.
Advanced power generator finished.
Yeah, we need at least the two generators, that much I remember. Maybe just the. Yeah, additional two tiles here, because we can build some of these outside. The concrete slabs, other stock is not so much, which is
building construction delayed.
Already then. Let's see. Okay, we are mining this at a rather rapid pace, and we have a couple more we could extract here. The lithium, of course. Well, we should take the game up on an offer, I think. If we can find a suitable tile for our mining station, so this should be good. Okay, good job, Vicon Vessel, doing a little more of a geological survey. We also need to get tabs of the enemy without getting killed ourselves, that would be slow. Does the medbay coming online? So what about the build queue? I think we're still actually have we pumped out a couple of things for wait, that's good. So we need the disruptor tanks. Okay, we have three of those. I guess we just move them to the friendly base just as the reinforcement for our artillery pieces if they did survive. I'm not quite sure. We had two to begin with, and they also set them to the protect order. I guess you just take them for the vehicles we brief and well, that's the scout flying for the enemy base again, which is just fantastic. Okay, that's the science vessel. Maybe we can stand this, but maybe this time we have to do after the mission is over, I'm not quite certain. Yeah, seems to be the case. Alright, maybe we can move our science officer inside there. So we... It's in the colony hub for whatever reason. Okay, we give this a spin. That's the best I can come up with right now. And if I can find our vehicle, because it's... yeah, there we go. Because it's dark green on a dark gray background, it doesn't make it particularly easy to see. Okay, the software tanks are finished. All of them, that's fantastic. That means we have completed one of the objectives again. Does not collapse automatically if you click on the mission button again, unfortunately. So, I think we have one tank still available, or one other piece, I would say, but it's not very good for point defense, of course. Alright, so we have another large deposit we could extract here. Or exploit for that matter, okay. I think they're outpacing us in the cargo bay department too because it's very far away from our base. I guess we see what we can make happen. So up to 55, which means we have to go over there and upgrade our barracks. As important is essentially right. And then the sick bay. All the wings, please. That's 5 each. And then we should also set down that... was it the colony house if it hasn't been already? So there it is. I just don't think we can upgrade this any further, but we can certainly beam down more troops by setting up the teleporter pad. I think that's one of the earlier structures becoming unlocked. And alright, that's all of our lovely phaser tanks. We already have it, so it's. Alright, I guess we just set them to to base defense as well, at least for the time being, before we have a sufficient force to wipe out the enemy base. Anything else we need to upgrade? I think the processor as well. So we have the power stations online, and the power situation is more than acceptable at the moment. So this is under wing apparently, so tracking systems. That should fix our base defense situation at the very least. Okay, let's see, we need a couple more doors, maybe 8 will do for now. Yeah, they're almost instantaneous. So let's see what the situation looks like itself. Also no activity, then we set down another mining outpost here right away, I think. It's a good idea that we can pump out as many vehicles we want to, more or less. Okay.
Vehicle complete.
Yeah, there's one type we could use. It's right in the path of the enemy, of course, so... Oh, they don't blast this... Yeah, they don't blast this thing to bits, I believe. They only bypass it by doing a little flyby and opening fire automatically. That's more or less what we're looking at the moment. Yeah. Okay, there's only one path here available for our scout, apparently, but it's relatively speedy. Also relatively, so this thing maybe not so much. Hopefully, yeah, so this thing should survive the encounter. Ideally, it's a little stupid to send it there, our undefended, of course. So, what are we looking at? We need a couple more vehicles, and we can afford to do so right now. So, let's see. Back to our proper base, and so this, I'm not quite sure if this will be a sufficient force, but we can at least set up a blocking formation next to the so we set them to. Pardon me, it's the other mouse cursor, of course, or the other mouse button, I should say. So we double click with the left one and then we attack on wood. Yeah, that should be good. And I don't think the protect order will apply to vehicles, you know. Passing by is just the structure seems to be a limited range, but I'm not quite sure how limited it is. So maybe this will be the blocking force. Should be good for now. And we assign them spot number 4 or 5 even. Okay, can we finally proceed with the base defenses again? And the shield generator is good, advanced mine. Maybe that's something we. So, Colonial Affairs we already have. So, once again, these structures have not become unlocked yet. Even though I'm not quite sure why this is the case. The construction app is fully upgraded. Maybe it's just the pop cap. You just have to be a little patient then and also set up a second resource processor, perhaps. Okay, but it's not completely depleted. We still get a trickle of minerals coming in. That's good, you know. Unlike some other games, you're not completely stuck if you run out of minerals. Let's collect that too. Should do the trick for now, and I really don't show up. So, wait, another one running dry apparently. So, this has been stuff with our security officer, but that matters not correct. Yeah, he's working the arsenal. You can, I don't know, maybe go to the vehicle yard for now. Operations officers, they are all purpose, you know, they're not specialized in anything in particular. And we can train someone in your name, which is good. So apparently our science officer did get blown up because, well, we lost our science officer, unfortunately. So he got beamed back to safety and will be available for the next mission. So, okay, ground scout. I don't think it would help us very much, so yeah, I'm not quite sure why this keeps not unlocking when I expected to. We have plenty of the super power. Okay, we do another one. We cannot even do this. And if it's just a matter of having insufficient resources, they would just yell at us, and we cannot even research anything at the moment anyway, because it's not that type of mission. And these other facilities, they are fully automated, I believe. Yeah, really beats me. We just have to. Really don't. Maybe it just comes down to building a vehicle of a particular type. But we haven't really unlocked anything, or all of them, including the cloak tank, for instance. Okay, disruptor tank, we put a couple more of those for the offensive role, and artillery doesn't seem to be as useful as I thought it would be, at least when the enemy has the defensive turrets in their base, which will be the case here, I think. Okay, double checking, 61 of 75, and yeah, raw materials, so we are completely out of raw materials, but we have processed all we could right now. So, okay, let's see about that mining outpost we could set up. So this is operational and doing a good job. And, okay. It's been repaired, but I don't think there are any other mineral fields nearby, are they? You see, though.
Vehicle complete.
Okay, more chaos and destruction in this area. Maybe we try this. I don't think it will work reliably, but I may be surprised. See, they don't even. Yeah. So these are our friends, I believe. Which is why they are so the other guys, they should shoot on sight, which is the case. But even so, they pass by here, they don't do anything in particular, as it would seem, which is a little puzzling. Okay. Yeah, so. I don't think that comes down to building a shield generator in the first case, but I guess I'm just. Yeah, maybe that's actually. Yeah, but really shouldn't be, but okay, we give it a spin. It will protect this side of the base anyway. Yeah, we have 62 of 75, and we cannot. Yeah, there we go, lovely. Not sure what it is, seems to be one vessel only. Can it please. So they're already respawning, which is good. Really. Yeah, on second thought, maybe actually build some shield generators on this side as well. How annoying is that, right? Okay. I will get it repaired automatically, it's not a problem. Yeah, that also finally we have access to it. Maybe we have to wait for the popcam to increase in some fashion, or maybe just to build the shield generator as a prerequisite, which doesn't make a lot of sense to me, but okay. Yeah, I think we have some energy to spare to set up some static artillery pieces, as well as the disruptor turrets, which seem to be quite useful, all things considered, and as usual, the enemy likes to bypass our defenses. Doesn't seem like even ground to me, and our vehicles also have problems pathfinding through the base, yeah, so not making it too crowded seems to be a good idea as well. And yeah, we need to set down 5 of those in total, one blocking the bridge, for instance, if we don't want to leave any vehicles behind.
Disruptor turret ready. Yeah,
fantastic.
Vehicle complete.
Last time we tried to set down some photon defenses, the game actually did a stupid thing again, so hopefully that won't occur. And we should also be able to fire over our buildings in the big, big arc, so we don't hit them by accident. I don't think this will occur, but you never know. Okay. Let's double check our power before we outpace her. So maybe set down another, just in case that would be a good idea, an advanced one. So also we have a couple to spare. Okay, so the build can be brief, so we have, under construction, that means we need two more. Afterwards we see what the popcap looks like, so we can set down our vehicles and attack the enemy base by escorted by a recon vessel, so we have a little bit of advanced running of what's going on. So this side of the base seems to be relatively undefended still, so we fixed that, of course. Yeah, with a couple. Yeah, I wish there would be an easier way to access it, but it's unfortunately not possible. We set the defenses here, and then we build another artillery piece, and I think it should be all. Maybe a shield generator if we can afford it. And then we also set down the farm, I believe it was, or the hunting grounds. They would take a load away from our energy grid, so they can hunt their own food, I guess. As in Birth of the Federation, more or less. Okay. I think it should also be one structure we have access to. So advanced mine.
Vehicle complete.
20 fans, I need disruptor. Yeah, colony house. No, that's not it. Yeah, I believe we should have access to this again. Yeah, livestock farm, that is. Okay, it's a rather a large structure, of course. And just to make sure that our vehicles can pass through here, we... so apparently this is too far away. Well, this here, we have lots of open space on this side, so it's not really a trick. And we can build a motor bus, I believe, to increase the pop cap even further if we absolutely have to. And I think it only means we need one additional... disruptor turret, I believe.
Disruptor turret ready.
I guess just put it here for now, and then we check our energy consumption again. That seems to be relatively good, so we, I don't know, put also a 2 generator at least around our colony hub, because if it does get destroyed, it's instant game over, I believe. It's the essential structure, same as the construction yard in Tabula Rasa, even though it is replaceable if you have a mobile one, a spare one someplace, okay? So fantastic, this has been taken care of, and it only leaves the objective to wipe out the enemy base. Yeah, so this is essentially it, right? So fantastic. We know about the Orions, and they will come into play later on, no doubt. And the story in this game is actually the primary reason, because I want to play and experience the new worlds for myself. So, alright, let's see about our forces. Yeah, what do we have left for that matter? So I guess we can leave the base behind for now. It seems to be able to fend on its own, including the the static defenses and okay, I think we just consolidate our position and then move all of our vehicles, because these guys are also capable of offending themselves. Yeah, don't double tip accident, thank you. They are on their way. And what do we have over here? The photon artillery also getting in position. And we also should check their orders, of course, so they don't run off once in a while. Let's see what we have on this side then. Also keep a couple more vehicles. Actually, we can just use one of the other recon. That's just not a massive problem. There's a cloak tank if you want to use it, but I don't think it's worth the expenditure, to be honest. And the vehicle ready point, of course, is not customizable, unfortunately. Right, you should go on. Yeah, there we go. We could scan this, but I don't think we'll offer anything at the moment. And since we're here, we can try and see. So, jump on. We have quite a bit of scanner range on that thing, apparently. So, no anomalies, unfortunately. So, there's nothing we can learn from this, more or less. It's nice experimenting with the systems, I have to say. So this is their tempo, quotation mark. Maybe build a couple of APCs just to see if we can take it over again. Yeah, would be a good idea. And not fumble it this time. Would be slow. And the unarmed. Well, doesn't really, actually it does matter, of course. Since they have to lower the shields than they are, like, personally. So I guess we build a couple of those. And then we still have plenty of... So, well, it's a little close. So maybe just... I don't think we need all of those, so disable or cancel a couple of these orders. Three arm transport should do the trick, I hope. Okay, maybe not that many. Okay, the base is secure. We have done everything that needs to be done, except for one upgrade apparently, and special weapons, whatever this is good for. And then we have a couple of crates I can see shimmering here with the, without any anti-aliasing, which was something I was unable to enable, unfortunately. It's very cool I got this game to run it all. Okay, let's see then.
Vehicle complete.
We have a plenty, so this is a plenty powerful formation already. We can just assign them to task force number 2, and then we move closer. And that hopefully should keep tabs on the enemies and also prevent them from breaking out into our direction. So I think this would be easier to direct from this, I suppose. Okay, over we move. And we wait for NPCs, and then hopefully we can take over the tempo, even though it's not a mission critical objective this time around. And hopefully we can complete the rest of the mission without the game screwing us over again, because it's really quite annoying. And are the other objectives, for instance, stabilizing the power source, should be done automatically, I believe. Let's head back to the base and see what we have in the queue still. Okay, that would take quite some time to get there, unfortunately. Unfortunately, that also doesn't refresh automatically, does it? Yeah, so it doesn't hurt out. Yeah, so. But I guess one for the artillery could come in handy, no doubt. And there we almost had the prop cap, apparently. But I think the queue should be finished automatically, and afterwards a couple of vehicles will be destroyed anyway. Okay, it's something made transparently brief, which is a nice feature in this game, for convenience sake. Okay, this can also come with us. We should reset the order, by the way, to attack on route, match with the other formation. And there will also swap position via brief if you give them more orders for whatever reason. Maybe it comes down to using a different set of AI parameters. Not quite sure. Okay, what about the APCs then? Okay, we have two incoming, or three even, and we should set them to their own squad, of course, so we can orchestrate this a little better without the other vehicles interfering, ideally. Okay, you are squad number three for the time being, and you can head over there right away. Okay, yeah, double click easier. There we go, I think the turrets are already firing on us. Until we incoming, there will be a lot slower, so we have to wait for their slow asses to get over there. Okay, so vehicle completed is the second to last, and also does actually update automatically, so better me. Doesn't show the progress here, unfortunately. Yeah, so they take the long and leisurely way around, that works for me. Only here, yeah, you have to click on the vehicle yard individually. Alright, so then we are completely maxed out. Yeah, one step at a time, folks. Yeah, very careful flying and maneuvering. And what did you want from us? Okay, it was just a mind-running dryer we did care about. So, alright, I think 4 is still 3, so we try that. And then we send them over as well. Okay, they can just park themselves here for the time being. Anything else we could pull with us? So, the swapper tank, the Strangler. This is our mine, having completely depleted this field of the radiolithium. Alright. That was just the matter of the waiting game, because well, these things are not very fast, even though they utilize anti-graph technology, of course. Well then. And yeah, they must move at 30 kph at the fastest, or something like that, yeah. Okay, then. Nothing else of interest. I did a little bit more scouting, but there are no additional fields of the lithium, unfortunately. But this is only a relatively small map, and none of these missions are designed to last particularly long. Yeah, because of the overall instability of the game, no doubt. But I'd like to take my time, experiment with these systems, and I think I'm getting better at the game as a result. And even despite its overall instability, I'm not hating it whatsoever. The voice overs are great, and I think from what I've seen from the story up to this point, looks very promising. And I'm very committed to this, and I also look forward to experience the entire story for myself in multiple directions, you know. The Klingons, the Federation, as well as the Romulan Empire, and a new player has made their appearance already, you know, the Orion Pirates. Not quite sure how tightly organized they are. But there was another Interplay title, I think it was the second Starfleet Academy game. Yeah, also featuring them as an add-on. I don't think it's on GOG though, some of the add-ons are missing for whatever reason. Okay, this is just a scout. Yeah, we have this formation, we can get a little closer finally, I think, and start blasting these defenses. And also keep these fucking vehicles off our back here. I think that was formation 5, yeah. And you can play the entire game from this screen, as the tutorials mentioned, but I don't think it's very convenient. It's also very sluggish, sometimes you want to see what's going on. Yeah, I would like to see, so we do just that. It also gives us a couple more frames. I'm not quite sure how well this runs on contemporary hardware for that matter, but we'll find out. Eventually, I think I would like to try this, but even back in the day, it probably was not the most compatible game in the world, right? Okay, so we start blasting, I guess. So the scout can also make himself useful by getting a little closer. It should not be a priority target. Okay, you guys, get over here, please. Blast everything, especially that vehicle yard of theirs. Yeah, this formation feature is a little annoying, yeah, because we only scooted here one vehicle at a time, take the leisurely way around because of pathfinding issues, I suppose. We completely annihilated as a result. Billy, what's our APCs doing? be flying through the base if I do, yes, okay. So that's fantastic. I think we leave this a sticky window for now. Okay. Ah, and whatever, we just blast him to pieces here with our remorse. Okay, we can take them over apparently. Yeah, they really are flying through that base for whatever reason. Yeah, we cannot capture this unfortunately. We have more work to do, folks. Head over here, start blasting. Also working relatively well for a change here, except for APCs apparently. And these guys refusing to move for that matter. Of course they're not part of the same formation, I guess that would be why. And there's some enemies, you know, in our rear here trying to flank us, could be the case, but we are blasting with artillery, but we should also get moving here, so not be a static target for their own artillery. We're kind of losing overview of what's going on, yeah. But I think we sort of come out ahead here, which is something. But we should really also focus fire on the structural enemy, ideally. So this cafuffle here, okay, anything else? Actually, there are two, interesting. Would explain the relentless wave of reinforcements yet incoming. Ah, so this screen doesn't always work, the kickbacking feature, unfortunately. Just blast them all to pieces, thank you. Yeah, find the victory ensured for the Klingon Empire once more, but their defenses weren't exactly much of a home about. I guess I went a little overboard with our disruptor tanks. But yeah, we did have lightning effects. I think the engine is capable of fending quite a bit of detail, especially for a game of this vintage and this rather polished state, yes. There we go. We have crossed all the defenses and all the opposition. And that means we should have completed the second mission in the Klingon campaign, which is indeed the case. And once again, it took quite a few attempts to get here, but hopefully the game will be a little more stable going forward. And there are more options, of course, I could tweak in X-Menure.
Mm-hmm. Your victory gives your family great honor.
Once again, yeah, we're showing us with honor. And I'm also quite proud of my accomplishments, if I do say so myself. But yeah, I think it was quite a fun mission, except for the one time it crashed completely and forced me to do a little more troubleshooting. But now it's just an old lucky game for you. It wasn't exactly in the best state to begin with, but I'm not a quitter and I'm quite determined to see it through to the end. Don't worry about it. But yeah, I think that should be all for this episode at the very least. So once again, I thank you for watching and I hope to see you next time.